start.
Good morning, friends. We are representing from NTU. We are here to say about Western culture.
Good morning, friends. We are the members of Team 3. Now we are going to debate on Indian culture versus Western culture. We are the supporters of Indian culture. Indian culture. India is a vast country. It includes different types of religions and cultures, and everyone follows their own customs and traditions.
At present, majority of the people are blindly believing that Western culture is wrong, but it is not right. But Western culture also is a part of India. We have adopted some rules from Western cultures, like professionalism, transportation, traffic rules, etc.
Yes, you are saying that you are adopting the transportation from Western culture, right? But Indian culture, we also have a transportation before started with the Western culture.
But when compared to Western culture and Indian culture, Western culture has a transportation is very good Indian culture, because when group of members are traveling in a bus, but their seats is fully filled. There is no space. The bus driver at the boarding part, they stop at the bus, and the person who is physically handicapped,
even Indian culture also says that help the people who are really needy. You are saying that when a person standing who is needed help, then they need to give a place.
But the driver communicates and the driver whose bus is very empty, he wants to communicate with very politely to the passengers, and he got an opportunity to go to the bus.
Indian culture says that we should respect others, and in Indian culture we see that even cows, we can worship the cows also, but not in Western culture it goes like this.
But Western culture we are follow the some relations like Jainism and Christianity. We are giving so much importance to the Christianity and Jainism.
Coming to relationships, in Indian culture we have more relationships. We respect others and we maintain this for long time.
Indian culture relationship is very stronger compared to the Western culture.
Yes, that's the only one. Western culture only one religion and one culture. There are union. But in Indian culture, so many religions, so many cultures, they do, there's some partiality to this religion, that religion.
I think it is not a partiality, it is mingling up with each other.
One thing you need to understand, culture is nothing but adopting of traditional and ethical values, right? In olden days, and even now also, turmeric is used as an antibiotic, which is born and adopted in India. But coming to Western societies, you make them through chemicals, which has an expiry date and is dangerous.
There are many medicines which heal the disease very quick.
But they have expiry date. But in Indian culture, medicines are prepared by ancient medicines which do not have which for kids like homeopathic medicines.
Homeopathy is from Europe, no?
It is used in Ayurvedic.
Ayurvedic, yeah. Homeopathy is from Europe and so many. Homeopathy is from Europe.
Ayurvedic,
there are so many advantages of Ayurvedic.
Medicines which are prepared in Western culture, they have expired as Jainism.
But nowadays, Ayurvedic also having some expired dates. Do you know that?
They don't have an expired date. Can you say an example?
Few days back, our ethics max or something. Someone has spoken about Ayurvedic and sitting in the that we always call it happy normal.
Coming to real. relationships in the poem Mother's Day. The poet Mother's Day, the author J.B. Priestley says that in Westernized societies, on the eve of Mother's Day, you just give her a bouquet and give her a sweet and again send her back to the orphanage home and hand it. But in Indian culture, you take blessings from her each and every day. You stay with her each and every day and give her lots of love, which is more important to Mother.
How many
of us are
doing that in Western culture also?
In Western culture, they are not doing. Simply, they are giving their love by giving a bouquet or some gift. But in Indian culture,
but they have same love towards
the
mother.
In
Indian culture,
we have to show how the mother. In Western culture, the children are left at the age of 1 year.
You said you need to show love. You have to show love each and every day. Not just because it's Mother's Day and you're showing love towards her and just giving a bouquet. You need to show it to her every day. Nothing is more important than a mother to each and every individual.
Not sir, how will she know that you have affection?
And Philip said that in one of the poems that he said that they show love to mother every day, but in Western culture they send out her, send out from home and they stay with her and get money. So, by the time they beg them, they were busy and can't spend with mothers and their parents. So they separate on the eve of Mother's Day.
Can you sort it?
I can't. In Western culture, went out to feed him and they stayed with you and had money. By the time they were busy in their works and helping money, how can they come and show their love every day? So they celebrate their Mother's Day in one day.
Coming to the in Indian culture, Buddhists prepare very helpful to the people, but in Western culture, to use the food, many health problems. For example, pizza, burger, this causes the health problems.
In Indian culture also, the people are eating the same.
That is also Western culture.
So, they are adopting agriculture, but according to Indian culture, we only eat the food from it. What is comes from nature, like fruits, vegetables, etc. But in Western culture, we eat pizza, burgers, which are not good for our health.
They are habituated from childhood, that's why they are eating. In Indian culture, it is not followed. In Indian culture, some people are
followed. What good food is that food? That pizzas and burgers, what good are they?
I mean, yes, they are adopting eating pizzas and it is good to health, so they are adopting. Oh. Maybe it is a bad, they are adopting that.
That's like fast foods, that's all. To make our hungry stomach, to fill it.
So many KFCs, McDonald's, they are adopting because it is
very. Because of the Western culture.
Western culture, so it is a healthy food, so they are adopting. But sometimes it may be.
But most of the, in the South India, most of them like sambar idli, which is good for them.
Yeah, they are also thinking that, we are thinking that it is good for their condition. Looking at their temperature, climatic changes, it is good to their health. So they are adopting that. Nowadays, we are also adopting.
Indian culture inspires many other countries. Indian culture is very greatest culture in comparison with many other countries. Like traditions and cuisine, very great. Because Indians are sari putting a matchbox expires to other countries because Indians have advanced knowledge in culture.
I didn't tell you. Western culture is modern culture, and most of the Indians are also now following Western culture. In Western culture, be very professional and we'll be having many things which are now adopted in India.
I want to give you one example. We have seen Chakumama movie. In that movie follows our dressing styles. Because our dressing style is very brave, they are compared to other
friends. You are saying that dressing culture, we are now, to look professional, we are now wearing professional dresses for offices, and also we are not wearing sarees and all. We are mostly preferring kurtis and overcoats.
But Western cultures adopting the Indian culture, they like the Indian culture, the way of sari, the way of dressing, they like them.
But mostly, the dressing of Western culture, we prefer only jeans and all that we borrow. And we will have the professional look.
When we are wearing a sari, we are much like a profession. That gives you respect. Many people gives you respect.
We cannot say that we will be having comfort also.
When we are going to many other countries, in that time we wear a sari. In foreign countries, gives you Indian gives you respect.
A girl will be having a respect whatever she wear.
Yes, I want to mention a point like religion. Someone spoke about religion, right? You know something, Buddhism born in India and it's a part of Indian culture. And you talk about transportation. Transportation is technology, not culture. Culture means ethics and values born in our country. And we had a great culture. No one has the right to criticize our culture. And talking about professionalism, right? A king has a great profession. He will rule his peoples like children. And we had Harappa culture. Have you had an idea about Harappa culture? Even Western culture don't have a way to clothes. We have dressing rooms to change our clothes. That's what culture is.
But Indians are also following the Western culture in dressing style.
That's the attitude of Indian problems or Indians' problem. That's not Indians' culture's problem.
But why they
because
of this, the
climate
is more in India.
Yes, that's following Western culture, increases the climate. Then follow Indian culture. Who said to follow Western culture? Indian culture never increases the climate. And you're talking about something like
eating. Because of their dressing style, the people are thinking wrong.
You know something? In Western culture, they wear coats. Why? Because the temperature makes them. Let me complain. The temperature makes them to wear clothes. I mean coats, because it's a cold country. But our country, we don't need this. Our modern country, we need to wear clothes such that the air enters into the body. That's why we prefer to do that. Now, what are people doing? They are putting ACs and wearing coats. What's the necessary to do that?
Following,
that's the problem of Indian attitude, not Indian culture's attitude. And someone said that like
the culture
depends upon the country and the situation based on the country and the temperature and the position of the country. Because they wear cold, because that is cold country, that's why they wear cold. And we wear kutas because it's our country and we have more temperature, that's why we wear kutas. And someone said about KFCs, right? Eating more KFC, there are many problems, and eating raw food never makes any problem. And their food is helpful to them, because in Western culture, eating chicken increases the heat in the body. But in India, there is no need of such, because we have sufficient heat.
You are saying that it is a problem of attitude in the Indian countries, Indian people. Why they are going abroad and learning more than here?
Because culture doesn't include education. And you know something, test tube baby was introduced in Germany, you are thinking. That's absolutely wrong. Test tube baby was introduced in Indian culture and Indian ethics. It is clearly written that Agastya was born in a pot. That's what Indian culture. We have all the ethics and we have all the technology written on a book. That's our fault, we did not follow it. And someone coming and reading and introducing in their country and keeping their name. That's the foolishness of our Indians.
Yes, but
Yeah, you are saying that Indian culture, your Indian culture is there. My last conclusion is we are not against to opposing to the Indian culture. Sorry, by some cases, Western culture is better than Indian culture.
So if you toss a coin on a plane field, you consider head as an Indian culture and Western culture as a tail. You can't say which is Western, which is wrong. What culture has, it has good and bad qualities. It depends on us how we utilize in our day-to-day life. But being born in India, I think you need to adopt the Indian culture. Thank you.
Thank you.